Hello, Bibs. Hello, everybody. How are you today? I was just thinking, look at this. It must be winter. It must be coming. I've got my jumper on today. It was a bit cold in the office, so I thought I'd put the jumper. So there you go. How are you all? Have you had a really good weekend, a really good week last week? It was just amazing. What were you up to? So exciting, exciting. Today, my business buzz. I was just wanted to talk to you about the book, obviously, because we've been talking about thriving by caring for the last couple of business buzz. But today I want to talk to you about self-publishing, because I've had so many people saying to me they have a book in them, they want to write a book, they love to write a book. They dream about writing a book, but they really don't know where to start. So I guess, probably about 3 years ago, 4 years ago, I was in the same kind of way where I had a little idea in my mind, but really, didn't really know how to put it together, where to start. So, I think a lot of things that we do nowadays, we can do it ourselves. So yes, it would be amazing if you're a publisher and you see Thriving by Caring and you want to have a read through it and decide that it's the best book of the year, which is obviously the best book of the year. Please contact me, just ping me an email or a little message on here. But if you're like me and don't want to wait until a publisher find you or give you, that kind of exposure, you can do it yourself. And so I wanted to show you the journey that I've had over the last, to self-publish. And the first part of it is actually start writing your book, and start writing. And that's a big part of it. So when you've got your idea for your book, a really good way to do is actually start creating a mind map. So what would the chapter look like? Do you have already ideas? Is it a business book? Is it, what type of book is that going to be? And so if you work in kind of in backwards, what is the mind might, what you will try to achieve by when you're trying to achieve it, and then you can work your way back. So for example, I had 10 weeks to write my book, so I knew that, by the 10th of September I wanted to have it published and arrived in the house so I could start launching it. So then I had 10 days before I had to print it. Then I had 7 days before everything was uploaded online. Then I had another 7 days before everything was translated. And then so you kind of work yourself backwards. So you're kind of really giving yourself a mapping of what you're going to be doing. The mind map itself, it's more about your chapters and what you're going to write in your chapters. What are they going to be? Are you going to have some pictures? Are you going to have some exercises? What are all the chapters are going to look like and how they're going to link into each other? So that's a really good way. Hi, Rachel. Hi, thanks to be here with me today. So once you've done that mind map, once you know where you are, once you know your timing, you really need to kind of get some time in your diary to do it. And perhaps you don't work, which is great. In that case, you can take, all the time you need. But, if you're working like me and I was trying to do the book at the same time as, running the business and the house and all that kind of things, you really need to be very, very, very strict with yourself to actually put, whether it's 2 hours, 3 hours a day, or whether it's a whole day a week, but really kind of focus yourself to have that time just for that. And then turn everything off, turn the emails off, turn the phone off, so you don't get distracted. And once you're in it, you're really in it. So that means that you can really advance and move on very quickly. So for example, this summer, what I did is I woke up at 5 o'clock in the morning, and from 5 to 9, I was doing 4 hours. Completely strictly 4 hours to actually write the book. So I knew that by 9 o'clock, that's it, I could kind of start the day and do other things. But that means that, it was 4 hours where I was very concentrated, very focused onto that, the writing, and onto what I wanted to do. So this, your time is really, really precious, and give yourself a target, because if you don't, you'll be like me on my first book, 3 years later. and you're still wondering why it's not finished. So really be strict with yourself and give yourself a target. You know, I'll be finished by December, or I'll be finished by March, or I'll be finished, you know, really, so you can, you've got that directions and you know you're going for it. So once you've got that, you know, kind of, you know, planned and scheduled, I've used leanpub.com. So leanpub.com. And leanpub.com is an online publisher. So you will log in. It's free of charge as well, which is fantastic. They download on your Dropbox some little files that you can just start writing your chapters. Leanpub has just been, I've written now my 3 books on Leanpub. Not only they've got an amazing support, their technical support is amazing. They've got all sort of videos to help you with your self-publishing, how to do this and how to do that. And so what Leanpub does is it uses something called Markdown. So when you write your book on the little files that they're giving you, you will then have to use, for example, maybe 2-star before and 2-star after the word if you want to bold something, or you want to have a C and a colon after if you want to center something. So there's a little technical things that you need to learn, but it's not difficult. And like I said, Leanpub is really, really, really good with their support. So when you get the couple of tricks to it, then you are on your way, because then Leanpub does everything for you. It does all the margin, it does all the formatting for the, so all you have to do is write, and it is just amazing. You can preview the book several times as well. So you'll do a preview and then you'll see it all coming up as it is, you know, as it could be. It's just really quite incredible to see that kind of format when it's done. It'll help you if there's fault or if there's errors or if there's things that you haven't quite, some photos that you've put in and were not right. So Leanpub is very, very simple to do, to use, but really excellent. I really loved it. Once you've done Leanpub and you've done your book and everything is kind of in there, then you can actually you can publish it. And this is a big part of it, isn't it? When you've done it, you're publishing it. And that means that people can buy on Leanpub your books as an ebook. So it could be an ebook, you can download it on PDF, you can download it on Kindle, and you can download it on ebooks. So there's 3 types of versions that you can actually download from Leanpub. Once you've done that, which is a big part of it, that means that you can actually then start going into another part, which is printing your hard copy of your book. And for that, I've used Lulu.com, and it's just simple, Lulu.com. And Lulu.com is a printer. So, and again, very, such a simple system to use. They're very user-friendly. You've got the little pop-up. If you need to speak to somebody, they can help you. But what happens in with Lulu.com, you create, again, you create your free kind of, you know, login. You'll go in there and all you have to do is you're creating your book in there. You can, and you'll upload the PDF that you downloaded from Leanpub. And once you've done that, then Lulu will actually automatically assign you, or ask if you want assigned an ISDN. So remember that, ISDN, this is really important. This is that bit here, you know, the code, you know, that you've got on behind the book. So you really need, if you're going to be selling the book, if it's just online that you're going to want it downloading, that's fine. But if you're going to be selling the book in shops or, you know, anywhere else, that they need to have that number here. So Lulu will automatically will assign you directly a code directly. So then you've got your code, and then you can then upload your cover. So this is pretty cool as well. You know, Lulu gives you some templates that you can use, so you can create something. I had mine done. Steve from SDS Graphic, I'll give you a little one on that one, but you know, this is just amazing. I love everything that Steve does for me. So Steve did all the cover for me. So I had just to give him the sizes, the format, and then he created that. So all I had to do was uploading the JPEG on lulu.com, press send, and that was it. That was absolutely it. And then Lulu actually print off, you know, your book, send, you'll buy a copy of it. So you can check, you know, if it's good quality, you know, it's just amazing. It's a book, you know, it's just crazy to think about it. So once you received that copy, it's really important to go back into lulu.com, and then lulu.com will say, are you ready to market your book? And then you can press yes. And this is where the magic starts, because lulu.com then send it out to all the other platforms that you can have online. So, you know, Goodreads, Amazon, all sorts of different platforms. So your book will already be automatically spread out by Lulu's marketing tools kind of things, which is amazing. However, it's always good to have to do two things. First, it's really good to do a really good bio of yourself, because there's a little trick there. If you're going to be selling your book on Amazon, for example, which Lulu will send out on Amazon, so you can sell it on amazon.co.uk or amazon.com. But you can also, so you'll go on Amazon and then you can create your Kindle version on Amazon, which means that it'll be picked up and very quickly you'll be able to have your book on Amazon much quicker, and then it'll come up on the different, you know, it'll come up quicker than anything else. So go Amazon Kindle, create your own account, upload the same PDF that you uploaded on lulu.com, because it's that, you know, ebook anyway, and then you can put the pricing, you can put your bio in there. And then you create, oh no, you don't put your bio in there, actually. That's why I want to tell you. So Amazon Kindle, you'll upload your ebook, you'll upload the prices, you'll upload where you want to actually sell it. You press send, and then Amazon will let you know yes or no, it's worked, or maybe you need to change something. But usually it's very, very simple. The second step with Amazon is you go on Author Central, Author A-U-T-H-O-R, central.co.uk or .com or .fr, whichever you are in whichever country. And you're creating your own author profile, which means that, again, when people are looking for you, they will find your profile on Amazon. And again, it's that kind of generation where you're creating a profile of author. And then when people will be able to find you when they look for author. And for your name. So that's really, really cool. So go on authorcentral.co.uk. You'll create a new author in there, create yourself, put your bio, and that's what I was saying earlier, just create a really cool bio. You can have a video on there, you can have, you know, what the book is about, you can, you know, have all sorts of little knick-knack on there. And then find your book. So the last step when you're on Author Central, it's you'll find your book. So you'll just type up the book that you've just put. So Thriving by Caring, select, it'll find it on Amazon. So you have to have it on Amazon first before it finds it anywhere else. And then once you've found it, this is it. Which means that when you are on Amazon and you're looking for author Claire Boscott, for example, you will find a page with all my books that I've written and all my books that are on sales on Amazon, which is pretty, pretty cool. So don't remember to do that, because that's a really big part, a really important part of making sure you're marketing yourself as much as you can when it's self-publishing. No one else is doing it but you. So authorcentral.co.uk or .com if you want to do the kind of global thing. And the last thing that I've done this year, which I hadn't done previously for Thriving by Caring, but I've just done this year, is the Audible version of Thriving by Caring. Yes! Ah, this is really, really exciting. I'm very excited to see it launch. Look, I'm just looking at it. It's there. It's there live on audible.co.uk. Thriving by Caring audiobook. Yes, it's quite incredible to see that. And also on audible.com, /thriving by caring, so you can see the Audible version. So if you fancy doing an Audible version of your book, you need to go on ACX, which is Audible Creation Exchange. So go on ACX, which is the Amazon version of your audio version. And then you really need to kind of take the time to read the specifics, because with that book, we had to redo the audios 3 times because there was something missing, or there was something, or it wasn't loud enough, or not loud enough, not too loud, or whatever specifics. Anyway, again, it's a new experience for me to have done the audiobook, and it's quite amazing. So I had that in the back of my mind when I've written the book, to have it in audio. And I wasn't sure, shall I do it, shall I not, shall I write the book, shall I read the book? And it was, although I'm French, as you know, and it's really different to actually be able to read a book and actually read it without stuttering, or read it without, you know, making any mistake, or concentrating on reading instead of, you know, sharing it from your passion. So I wasn't sure if I'd be able to do it, especially on a time scale that I had, because I needed to have it live kind of by beginning of October. So this is why I had it done. So I went on to fivers.com and I listened to several ladies. I wanted a woman, but because obviously I'm French with my French accent, I really would have wanted somebody who had maybe a bit of a similar accent as me. So I was trying to look for, you know, somebody. So there was 3 or 4 different ladies that I've been emailing. When you do that, ask them to do a test. So send them a couple of pages of your book, and then they can do the test. They can read through it, and you can listen to it. And I think when I've done the ebook, it was all about, I've asked a lot of people what's most important to you when, you know, when you listen to books. And I think it all came back to the warmth, and the voice itself need to be attractive, and the warmth in the voice was very important. So so I found my voice. I found Sandrine Daudet, which she is French, but she's been living in England, and she's a professional voice recorder. So she does, you know, she does books, she does radios, she does a lot of different things, and we kind of connected as well quite a bit straight away. I think maybe the French connections was there as well, but she really loved the book, which really helps really when when you've got somebody who really thinks that your book is interesting. And so she's really helped me doing, well, she did, you know, all the narrative of the book. So we had 92 files to upload. Yes, because there's all loads of different little mini chapters. Within each chapters, there's little mini chapters, which I probably didn't make it easier for her. But it sounds amazing. That's all I have to say. So if you want to, if you listen to book, I mean, I'm a big fan now of audiobook myself. I listen to books every morning when I walk. I do my walk at 7 o'clock. I put my earplugs in and I listen to books, because it's a fantastic time to be able to listen and get inspired by other people. So if you want to listen to Thriving by Caring instead of reading it, yes, you can go on audible.co.uk/thrivingbycaring or audible.com, and then you'll find it there as well. But for you, if you're writing a book and you want to have that experience, it's an amazing way to share what you've got, you know, to tell people. And I think a lot of people are scared or worried to write books, because who's ever going to read my book? Why would somebody read my book? Oh, people are going to laugh at me. Oh, no one wants to, you know, read my books. And, you know, perhaps not, and perhaps yes. So if you're self-publishing it, you know, you've got all those help out there, which really kind of, you know, there's loads of things that you can do now by yourself. Maybe it takes a little bit more time, but it's such an achievement as well. I mean, when I first received Thriving by Carrie, Thrive with a Hive, the very first book, I felt like I had, you know, I had just had given birth to my third child kind of things. Not as much for the second one, but very, very exciting to hear the audiobook. So it was, it's all something, you know, so it's very, very warm inside and it makes you feel really good. And you all have, if we have a message, why not sharing it with people? You know, if you've got something which is a, it could be a story, it could be a business idea, it could be something that you want to share because you've got amazing, you know, creative, you know, mind, just do it, you know, just go and do it, you know, don't let yourself, you know, your self-talk take you out of that, because it's an amazing, amazing experience. So your steps: leanpub.com, lulu.com with your ISDN, make a really, really good bio, and then go on Amazon Kindle. And Amazon Kindle, you can upload your book as an ebook. Then you go on Amazon Author Central to create your author books. So then you can link it together. And then if you want to do your final version of Audible, you go on ACX. And then you'll be able to then upload your version as audio. So that's it. It's a bit of a longer one today than we normally do, but I felt that it was something that, you know, I've wanted to talk to you about, because it's so important. And I've had so many people saying to me, oh yes, I'd love to do it. And they don't necessarily go on and do it. So go on and do it. Go and do it. You know you can do it. You've got all the tools now. And if you need some help, you know where I am. Message me. Send me a little message. Or if you want to go on busyqueenbee.com, you can see the blogs as well. I've put the links on there as well. Or clairebosscott.com/author, of course. You will see all my books in there. So don't forget. Remember, whatever you do, do it. And then share the love with everybody else. Yes, share, you know, tell people what you've done, why you've done it, how you've done it. Because once you're passionate about it, people will be passionate with you. Right, peeps, I'll leave you for now. Thank you very much for joining me. I hope you have a really, really buzzing evening. And if you have any questions, you know where I am. Bye for now.